There's one thing you can never have enough of when you practice guitar. And no, it's not more practice time, it's progress. Because let's face it, we all want to make more progress in less time. And one way to improve faster is to learn something that few guitar players know about. And it is this. Many of your musical skills do not improve in a straight line. Instead, they often improve by following a principle that I discovered by accident while I was in college. And let me tell you, not knowing that principle almost made me quit guitar. Here's how it happened. In my freshman year of college, I took an ear training class, and I already had pretty decent guitar technique at that time, and I knew a good amount of music theory, but I've never trained my ear up until that point. And that ear training class made me seriously wonder if I had what it takes to call myself a musician. Our professor taught us how to transcribe rhythms, melodies, and identify chords by ear, but I wasn't getting it, and I couldn't keep up with the class. And the worst part was, everyone seemed to be leaving me in the dust with how fast they were improving. And I was feeling helpless, like a turtle on its back. And it was not a nice feeling for somebody who already saw himself as an advanced guitar player. But I really wanted to do well in the class, so I practiced ear training for 2 hours per day with the piano and asked my professor to help me during office hours, and I practiced singing ear training drills while walking on campus in between classes. And then I took the first of the 3 semester exams, and I scored 78%, a grade of a C. It was far less than I expected considering the work I put in. But I didn't give up, so I worked even harder leading into the second exam. I practiced every day, I met with my teacher every chance I could to get extra help. And my friends were all making fun of me because I didn't go out to party with them. Instead, I stayed in my dorm room to work on my ear training exercises. I worked so hard, I started to have dreams about ear training. So then the second exam rolled around, I took it, and I scored a 65%. I got a D. That's right, my skills got worse as the semester went on. Now, let's pause here. Imagine you were me. What do you think you would do in this situation at this point? I had basically 2 choices. I could drop the class and admit that I failed and wasted thousands of dollars of my parents' money, or I could keep going and give it my all, despite mounting evidence that my ear training skills were doomed to suck forever. I chose to keep trying, because persistence is one of my highest personal values. So I kept on practicing as before, but honestly, I was starting to give up hope. And then it happened. It was about 11 days before the final exam, and I suddenly felt like Peter Parker in Spider-Man after he got bitten by the super spider. I went to sleep one night, and I woke up with ear training superpowers. No, I didn't suddenly get perfect pitch, I still don't have perfect pitch, but I now could write down melodies after hearing them, transcribe rhythms, and sing chord progressions like someone installed an ear training app into my brain while I slept. I took the final exam and I got a 96%. And that was the proudest moment of my musical life at that point. I felt like Rocky after he won the heavyweight boxing championship in Rocky II. What made this possible? The answer is retroactive progress. This is what often makes or breaks your guitar playing. Many of your most important skills improve retroactively, meaning you have to keep practicing for weeks or sometimes months before seeing a holy crap, what just happened breakthrough like I did. And when that happens, you feel like Thomas Edison when he invented the light bulb and changed the world after famously failing for 10,000 times. Now think back to my story. All the work I did throughout the semester compounded, reached a tipping point, and a breakthrough happened. It didn't come out of nowhere, it happened retroactively. Now the problem is, most guitarists have no clue what retroactive progress means or that it even exists, and most give up just before the breakthrough happens, like the man during the gold rush who stopped digging 3 feet short of gold. So now that you know one of the most powerful secrets about making progress on guitar, here's how you make retroactive progress work for you. First, recognize what skills improve retroactively, because not all skills improve retroactively. Some actually improve slowly and gradually in more or less a straight line. Retroactive progress usually happens on undoing bad habits in your playing and learning skills that are way underdeveloped compared to your other skills. For me, it was ear training, and later on, it was about learning to play rhythm guitar in time. For you, it might be sweep picking, it might be vibrato, it might be finger independence in your fretting hand, or it might be ear training, like me. Or it might be something else. Point is, when you know that a skill is improving retroactively, you reset your expectations and start thinking long-term instead of short-term. because if you don't reset your expectations, you're gonna feel angry like Karl Marx on Wall Street because your playing doesn't improve right away. Second, there is a big difference between waiting for a retroactive progress breakthrough and not knowing how to practice guitar. And the more you learn about practicing, the more certain you feel that you're on the right track in every practice session, because even if you don't see earth-shattering results right away, you know you're moving towards your goal. When I was practicing ear training, the only certainty I had came from doing what my teachers told me to do. But I was acting mostly on faith. I had no proof that my hard work would ever pay off. In your case, you can benefit from experiences of thousands of guitarists just like you who came before you. Now, think back to the Thomas Edison example. As the story goes, he failed 10,000 times before he finally invented the light bulb. Do you think Edison enjoyed failing that many times? I don't think so. But I do think he saw his work the way I encourage you to see your guitar practice, as a never-ending process of self-discovery and self-improvement. Enjoy the process as much as you enjoy the results, if not even more. I would bet that Edison enjoyed the process more than he enjoyed all the money and the fame that came with his success. It was that love of the process that kept him going, and it is that same love of practicing that keeps your favorite guitar players getting better all the time. If you think of practicing as hard work, it will be hard, and your progress will be slow. But if you enjoy the good and the bad parts of practicing, then the sky's the limit to your progress. And more importantly, you also enjoy every minute you spend with your guitar. Now, remember my story? During the second exam in the semester, I scored less than I did on the first exam. My grades actually slipped, even though I was working harder than ever before. What that means for you is, sometimes your skills will go backwards during the retroactive progress phase. And here's the key, and this is important. When your skills go backwards, it usually means you're getting closer to a breakthrough. And ironically, that is when most people give up, because they think that they're on the wrong track. Now, why do your skills go backwards? There's many reasons. And here's one example. When you start working on undoing a bad habit, it is firmly ingrained into your muscle memory. The new habit is very weak. And the moment you stop paying attention to working on the new habit, what happens? Your hands immediately go back to the old habit, because that's what your hands are used to and comfortable doing. This is another example why retroactive progress takes time. And as you practice, your old habit becomes weaker and the new habit becomes stronger. And there comes a point when both habits are about equal in your muscle memory. And that is when your brain gets confused and it doesn't know what to do. You now have to think about how to do a certain motion your hands did on autopilot before. And that's when it feels like your skills go backwards, because you've taken a subconscious habit that you used to do without thinking and made it conscious. And this is the point where most people give up. What you should do instead is just press on and make the new habit even stronger until it becomes the new default setting in your hands and your muscle memory, and the old habit vanishes like a bad dream. And your sudden explosion of progress makes all the struggle and all the frustration worth it. And finally, once you know that something improves retroactively, the sooner you start working on it, the faster you reap the magic benefits of retroactive progress. It's just like investing money. The sooner you start, the faster the magic of compound interest starts to work for you. Look at it like this. If this is where you are today, a year from now, you can be in one of three places. If you keep doing what you've always done, you're gonna get the same results you've always got. If you get sloppy and inconsistent with your practicing, you develop bad habits and lose the skills you have today. Or if you get on the retroactive progress path, at first, it seems like you're doing nothing at all, because your progress has a delayed effect to it. But when it comes, it makes all the work more than worth it. And the sooner you start, the easier it is to change the way you do things, like taking a slight turn to merge onto a new highway that takes you where you want to go. The longer you wait, the more bad habits you have to undo later, and the longer it takes to make up the lost time and lost ground. And I want to add one more point here, which is to not put the rest of your guitar playing on hold to master something that improves retroactively. Remember that no skill in your guitar playing is more important than your entire guitar playing. So set aside time to work on all skills that make you better. Just be aware that some skills are going to improve with a delayed response. Trust the process and let the retroactive progress do its magic for you. This is how you make your guitar practice enjoyable and get better faster. Hey, did you like the video? If you did, then go ahead and subscribe to this channel and also hit the bell so you're notified every single time I upload new videos just like this for you. And one more thing, if you're not interested in playing guitar fast, then ignore everything I'm gonna say next. But if you've already tried the old starting slow and gradually building up speed method and you've hit a plateau and you already know that the traditional methods for building speed don't really work all that well, hit the link below and I'm going to show you a new and different way to build speed that most guitarists don't know about that helps you get faster without doing any slow practice. It's pretty cool. I taught it to hundreds of guitar players who paid thousands of dollars to watch me teach it live to them. You get to watch a recording of the masterclass. Just enter your email address and I'll send it right over to you. Hit the link below and I will see you soon.